students, the families are actually COVID. Suffering.
Oh, COVID struck. God.
In fact, even right. I have tested positive. I'm on the recovery mode.
Oh God. Yeah, I think इस समय पे जो भी टेस्ट करवाएगा वो पॉजिटिव ही आएगा. I mean, this is the situation right now.
That's true.
Yeah. So all you can start, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay. Good afternoon, students. Finally, we have been able to overcome all odds of technical glitches and technical issues. We have Dr. Swami with us. He is the director, the dean of DME, the management school. He is a professor in business studies. He's a PhD holder, and he has worked, he has got his expertise across disciplines of what I see in his bio, from economics to pol science to philosophy, and his MBA in finance and marketing. So you have a lot to actually look forward to with regards to your questions, that if I want to do a BBA, what should I do it in? Should I do a BCom or a BBA? Or should I go in for more other courses? And today he's here to enlighten us about all the IP University courses. So IP University, I do understand that a lot of us have Delhi University on our minds. Supposedly the biggest university in Asia and world's best. Trust me, I'm a product of Delhi University and there are no big bones about it. When you go inside, you realize sometimes it is only noise and not much content. With Dr. Swami, who's been decorated across these diverse backgrounds in education, a PhD holder, an MBA, and of course, bachelor's in different majors like eco and pol science. He also holds certifications from a lot of B schools, big B schools like IIM of Bangalore and Calcutta, IIFT of New Delhi. So he has his excellence in the field of research across domains. Now, I'm not going to delay this anymore. Over to Dr. Swami and Dr. Shalini. Dr. Shalini, thank you so much for helping us organize this. And Dr. Swami, we're just looking to hear it from you. Thank you.
Thank you, Sheetal. I'll begin by sharing my screen. Shalini ma'am, you need to enable the screen sharing. Yeah, Dr. Shalini.
Done that. Okay. Yeah, I've done that. Just done that.
So students, we are going to talk about IPU today, but at the same time, I would also draw a comparison between DU as initiated by your favorite teacher, Sheetal. Now, let us begin with IPU, and as we will move ahead, I would be drawing many kinds of comparisons, wherein I would also be telling you that University of Delhi does not compete with IPU, but it complements IPU. So let us start by having a look at the picture of IP University. Well, you can see the picture. Now it's located in Dwarka, Blue Line, Sector 14, Metro is the nearest metro, right? Yeah, Shalini ma'am, we are on slide 2 now.
No, sir, it is still on slide 1, that first slide with the pic.
Now?
No, sir, no? It is not changing.
Okay, fine, no problem, I've got the point. Now this again is a
yes, now it is changed, sir.
IPU. Students, in today's webinar, we are going to talk about these things. First, what IP University is, then what are the courses, then the admission process for 2022, which is directly relevant for you. Fee structures, obviously, your parents' hard-earned money, and the scope after various professional courses, right? Now, let us start with the first part of our presentation, which is regarding IP University. So, let me begin like
Sir, you're not audible. I think there's some problem with the net. Is it mine or? Sir, are you there?
No, I think sir has lost the connection.
He's lost the connection.
His screen is frozen.
He's in office. I don't know why the problem is happening. I can see from his background. I thought that he's working from home, but he's in office. He will again rejoin. Some problem with the network there.
Dr. Shalini, is it possible for you to share the screen and continue till the time sir joins in?
The presentation is with sir. I don't have the presentation. So he's not picking up the phone. Probably, या तो कई बार ऑफिस में नेटवर्क वो वोल्टेज फ्लक्चुएशन हो जाता है, लाइट चली जाती है तो एकदम से कनेक्शन सब खत्म हो जाता है, तो तब इन्वर्टर दोबारा चलता है उसके बाद वो आता है, तो probably लाइट फ्लक्चुएशन हुआ हो. He's not picking up the phone also.
I've admitted, sir. He's joining
right,
back.
Sir, I've admitted him. I'll just make him co-host, then only he will be able to share his file.
He is the co-host now.
Yeah. Yes, now, sir. So you can share the file.
So maybe you can put off your video so that in case there's too much
no,
of...
No, it's not a problem.
It's not a problem? Okay.
So students... Delhi has got, I'll continue with where I logged out. So the correct term to be used is NCR rather than Delhi, because the way Delhi has expanded, it has expanded southwards to Gurgaon and Faridabad, northwards to Ghaziabad, eastwards to Gautam Buddha Nagar, so on and so forth. So the correct term to be used for Delhi is actually NCR. So Delhi NCR, I was telling you, is an area which has got hundreds of universities. And there are four kinds of universities, students.
We've lost him again, actually.
I don't know what is happening. This is, I mean, this
jinxed.
Is the first, the first
the
time
which
is happening. He has taken the sessions from his home also in Sonipat, and then also it went off so beautifully on Saturday, Sunday.
Can you check if he can give you the presentation at least?
I'll,
you can start. That's why I asked him to switch off the video. Bandwidth thoda load kam ho jata hai.
He's joining again.
Oh. Students, please be patient. I know you people are, and I'm glad about that.
This is the first time which is happening with us also. We have conducted webinars on Saturdays and Sundays as well. And he has taken the webinars from his home. And his hometown is Sonipat. वहाँ पे इतने बढ़िया first class वो चला. आज यहाँ college में बैठे हुए हैं sir अपने office में. और आज सर को पता नहीं कॉलेज में नोएडा में बैठ के कैसी दिक्कत हो रही है.
ओके आप सर को co-host बना दो.
हाँ, I will just make him co-host. Yes. Sir, you are the co-host now.
Okay. I'm sure it will not be lost this time. So students, in Delhi NCR, we have hundreds of universities, but there are two major universities. I was telling that there are four kinds of universities, the central universities funded by the central government, the state government universities like IPU, then the private universities like MET, and then deemed universities like JP, right? Now, Delhi has got two major universities. One is University of Delhi and second is IPU. Why I'm saying that Delhi has got two major universities? Because both these universities have got 90 plus affiliated colleges. So we'll begin with the point that Delhi has got two major universities, and these two universities do not, mind it, they do not compete with each other. They complement each other. How? They complement each other in the sense that University of Delhi is all about academic courses and IPU is all about professional courses. I'll be telling you the difference between academic and professional courses in a while. Before that, about IPU, the first part of our presentation. Now, IPU is ranked as, let us see what is the ranking of IPU. It's 79 out of 875 universities in our country, which means it is ranked among the top 9% universities in India. Top 9% means 91% universities are below IPU. The university rank is 79 out of 875. As far as law courses are concerned, the rank is 12th. Engineering, it is 86th. And business management, the rank is 51. It has got NAC A grading, and AIU's membership is there, which means any degree from IPU is recognized by all universities in this world. I told you there are around 95 colleges which are located in Delhi and NCR. When I say NCR, it includes Gurugram, Faridabad, Ghaziabad, Gautam Buddh Nagar, which is Noida, Greater Noida. So there are colleges of IPU in Delhi and NCR. There are around 80 courses about which I'll be telling you briefly today. And it's a huge university with 81,000 students. Moving ahead, before we move, I would be telling you what is the difference between an academic and a professional course. As I said, University of Delhi is all about academic courses, while IPU is all about professional courses. So please try to understand this. An academic course like BA History Honours or Psychology Honours or Sociology Honours or maybe Physics Honours, it's an academic course which gives you knowledge and knowledge and knowledge, and therefore the output is knowledge enhancement, no doubt. But a professional course like hotel management, like BBA, like BBA LLB, BA LLB or journalism, a professional course gives you number one, knowledge, number two, how to apply that knowledge means skills, and third is attitude. Attitude means how to perform while having a career in that profession. Therefore, what is the output? The output is placements. I can conclude by saying that a professional course trains a student for a specific profession, while an academic course does not train you for a specific profession. It gives you, it enhances your knowledge only. In Having talked about the difference between academic and professional courses, let me talk about the notable alumni of IPU. Well, this is a face which everyone here recognizes. Yes, Tapsi Pannu did her BTech Computer Science from IPU. Then we have Gaurav Sharma, a very popular novelist, settled in Canada. He also studied at IPU. Then Gaurav Gogoi, the deputy leader of Congress in the Lok Sabha, did his engineering from IPU. Well, you also recognize this face. Amish Devgan did his journalism from IPU. Well, you must be knowing about movies like Gangs of Wasseypur, Masaan, Zuma, etc. All these were produced by a production house, which is owned by Gurit Monga, who did her journalism from IPU in 2004. Dear students, the list is very long. IPU has got many celebrated alumni, but considering the time, I would stop here only. You can search it on the Google. Now coming to the second part of our presentation, which is regarding the courses at IPU. Now, please try to understand there are two kinds of courses. One, which are stream neutral. Stream neutral means you may have done your 12th with humanities or commerce or science, maths or bio or even vocational. You are eligible for these courses. Stream neutral means these courses do not require any stream. They don't say that you should have so-and-so stream at your 12th, then only you can take admission in these courses. So among these stream neutral courses, I would be taking up questions on these towards the end of the session. So among these stream neutral courses, we have BLLB, BBLLB, BAJMC, Bachelor of Arts, Journalism and Mass Communication, BBA, then Bachelor of Hotel Management and Catering Technology. All these courses at IPU are stream neutral courses, means whichever stream you have at 12th, no matter, you are eligible for these courses. Now, contrary to these, we have courses which are not stream neutral or which are stream specific. Stream specific courses means, for example, Bachelor of Technology, BTech, or Bachelor of Architecture, or Pharmacy, or MBBS. For pursuing these courses, you need a specific stream at 12th. Say, for example, for doing BTech, you need to have physics, chemistry, and maths PCM at your 12th. Similarly, for courses like MBBS or pharmacy or nursing, you need to have physics, chemistry, biology at your 12th. So, to conclude about the courses, two kinds: stream neutral, the students from any stream can take admission, and stream specific, students only from a specific stream at 12th can take admission, right? So this is the broad overview of the courses at IPU. So IPU has got, to summarize this, IPU has got BLLB, BBLLB, BBA, BHMCT, BAJMC. It has also got BTech, Architecture, Pharmacy, Nursing, right? So these are about the courses at IPU. Now, coming to the admission process. Now see, when we talk about the admission process, you need to understand something very important. Again, there are two kinds of courses. One for which national level tests are available. Second, for which national level tests are not available. So wherever national level tests are available, IPU does not conduct its own entrance exam. Rather, it considers the scores of national level tests. For example, for BTech, if you want to do BTech with IPU, IPU will not conduct any entrance exam of its own. You need to appear at JEE. Similarly, for BALLB and BBLLB, you need to appear at CLAT, which is a national level exam. Similarly, for architecture, NATA is there. For MBBS, BMS, BHMS, NEET is there. Then there are courses like journalism, BBA, BCA, for which no national level exam is available. Therefore, IPU conducts its own entrance exam. Hotel management is an overlapping course for which national level exam is available. At the same time, IPU is also conducting its CET. Okay, so if you want to do the courses written on the left hand side, BTech, BLLB, BBLLB, etc., you need to appear at national level exams. And today is the right date for holding this webinar. Let me tell you the entrances, the national level entrances, the forms are already open. Say, for example, for CLAT, the forms are already open for 2022 admissions. So what is this? Well, rupiah paisa, yes, your parents' hard earned money, right? Money does not grow on trees. Therefore, in the next part of our presentation, we are going to talk about the fee structures at IPU. Now, my dear students, again, as I said, we are located in Delhi NCR, which is a hub of educational institutions. You have got institutions having fee structures ranging from 10 lakhs per year to 50,000 per year, or maybe 10,000 per year. So 10,000 per year to 10 lakh per year, that is the range of fee structures available in Delhi NCR. For example, institutions like OP Jindal Global University, Ashoka University, Bennett, their fee structures are very high. These are private universities. On the other hand, there are universities, government universities like IPU, for which the fee structures are very reasonable. The fee structures are there, they are quite reasonable. And whichever course you do with IPU, the fee structure will be ranging between 80,000 to 1,10,000. Say, for example, for law courses, the fee is 79,825, which means roughly 80,000 only, right? Also, the fee structure varies between different colleges at IPU. In some colleges, the fee structure may be, say, 10 to 15,000 more. In some, it may be less. But overall, we find that 80,000 to 1,10,000 is the fee structure applicable to all courses at IPU. And yes, being a government university, there are no hidden charges. Moving ahead after the fee structures. Well, students, I hope you are aware that Delhi is the richest state in our country. And the students studying at IPU get advantage of this richness in the sense that IPU has got marvelous, very good scholarship schemes. One very popular scheme is MCM, Merit Come Means. If you are a student of IPU, you have got 60% and no reappear, then in that case, you are sure to get the advantage of Merit Come Means scholarship scheme. There are many other scholarship schemes, but MCM is the most popular one for which you are eligible. We have reached the last part of the presentation, students. And the last part is talking about the scope of the various professional courses available at IPU. Before this, students, we talked about the difference between professional and academic courses. But let me tell you, with globalization, privatization, and liberalization, the government sector is shrinking and the private sector is expanding. Therefore, what is the need? The need is of academic courses or professional courses. Obviously, the need is for professional courses. Talking about the scope of law courses, well, a law student can have four career options. First is litigation. You can put on a black coat and you can become an advocate. Second is you can join a law firm. You can have a job with organizations like KPMG or Ernst & Young or Genpact. All organizations need lawyers, so you can catch up a job. If you are interested in becoming a judge, you can go for various competitive exams. And judiciary is something you can become a magistrate. I also tell in my webinars that politics is a career option for law graduates. Why so? Because we find that politicians throughout the world, I don't know what is the reason, but majority of the politicians throughout the world are law graduates. I can give you various examples. Jawaharlal Nehru ji, Sardar Patel, Mahatma Gandhi, Barack Obama, and the recently elected Vice President of USA, Kamala Harris, all are law graduates. So I can comfortably say that politics is also an option for law graduates. To summarize this slide, litigation, joining a law firm, judiciary, and politics, all four are the career options after law course. Now, if you do a course in hotel management or media, we are also going to talk about the career options. Well, students, this journalism and mass communication, this mobile has changed the entire scape of, it has changed the entire landscape of jobs after a journalism course. Yes, before OTT, the scope was limited, but with OTT platforms, the scope for journalism courses has become, I can say, fivefold or tenfold or whatever you try to understand. So if you have done a journalism course, then content writing, anchoring, video editing, filmmaking, print journalism, the list is very long. You have various career options if you pursue a journalism course. Mind it, I am talking about IPU courses, and IPU does not compete with DU, like your ma'am said, in the sense that DU is all about academic courses and IPU is all about professional courses. If you happen to do BBA, then in that case, students, there are five career options. What are those? Marketing, finance, HR, operations, and international business. So BBA, one point I would like to put forth here, that somehow the placements after BBA are better than MBA, better than that after MBA. You know why? Because multinationals want a student at 22, not at 25. Because they want to mold you according to a very, very customer-oriented attitude. Therefore, we find that for BBAs, companies line up at institutions. And it does not mean that you are not going to do MBA. The model is that BBA means theory, then practice, at least 2-3 years of job, then MBA. So this is the model which is working, rather than the old model which said that BBA, MBA, then job. It's BBA, job, and then MBA. These are the five career options after a BBA course. Moving ahead. If you are interested in a hotel management course, then front office is one career option. Whenever you enter a hotel, the person who meets you and greets you is a front office manager. Housekeeping is another option. The person who maintains the property is the housekeeper. And then the kitchen and the bar. So food and beverage is another career option if you pursue a hotel management course. And yes, if you have some entrepreneurship zeal in you, owning a restaurant is also a very good option after a hotel management course. Well, I know during the presentation there are many queries. We would be taking up all these queries towards the end. Another 5 minutes and we would be taking up the queries. Well, if you happen to do B.Tech, then Sheetal, do we have science students here today? Okay. So
yes,
if you
a lot of science students.
If you happen to do B.Tech, then I have something to tell you here. Why I am talking only about the scope of B.Tech computer science in this presentation? Because students, technology is something which is of very paternalistic nature. The patterns, there are patterns. So when India became independent, the country was building and civil was at the top. Then mining became very good, a very good branch. Then came electrical, then mechanical, then electronics, then computer science. But yes, computer science is something which is here to stay for a very long time. Students, I can tell you, when I did my 12th in 1990, this computer science branch was yet to take its birth, or probably was about to take its birth. So as far as engineering is concerned, I must tell you that civil, electrical, mining, mechanical, automobile, they don't have very good scope. I must tell you, and I'm ready to face queries on this. I believe that the branch which is having large number of jobs, and such jobs are going to stay for coming 5 decades, that branch is computer science. Yes, electronics is close to computer science, therefore it is also doing little well, but I can tell you, computer science is the branch of the future. Digitization, we have just seen tip of the iceberg. It is a long way to go as far as digitization is concerned. And therefore, I am talking in today's presentation only about the scope of BTech computer science, and I'm skipping the scope of other branches of engineering. So when we talk about computer science, cloud computing is a very important area. Artificial intelligence is another important area. Cyber security, the Internet of Things, and new areas keep on coming as far as computer branch is concerned. But yes, I can safely say that computer science is a branch which is going to have good career options at least for the coming 5 decades. I cannot thank COVID for this. Moving ahead. Architecture, yes, this again is a branch which is into the infra development, the housing sector, etc. In a country like India, where we have 18% of the world population, you can imagine the ever rising need for the housing sector. Although the housing sector in the post demonetization era is facing a low business, but still I believe that with 18% of the world population, housing sector can never face a downfall. Similarly, infra, roads, bridges, new projects keep on coming. We had Purvanchal Expressway inaugurated recently. So when we talk about all these infra projects, the bullet train projects are there. So architecture is a course which is a 5-year course. And after that, you have scope in these areas. We have almost come to the end of the presentation. The biology courses, after B Pharma, you can become a scientist, you can become a medical representative, or even you can have a medical store. And now, students, the question which is coming to your mind, which course is good for me or best for me? Well, I could have answered this question like Nirmal Baba, that do this thing and you will have a good future. But I can tell you, Nirmal Baba is good only on television. The answer to this question, that which course is good for me, is like this diagram. I hope you'll remember this diagram. This diagram best answers this question. How? Whichever course you see in this world, 25% people do exceedingly well, 25% people, they do not do well, and the majority, 50%, they do well, they are happy, they are satisfied in their lives. Students, I can tell you that 30% graduates from our IITs, or even the best institutions in this world, they never settle down in their career. So institutions or courses do not matter. What matters is what our last slide will tell you. So regarding this slide, yes, whichever course you do, you can have a good career. Now, what is the mantra for success? Well, to quote Rajesh Khanna from film Bawarchi, It is so simple to be happy, but so difficult to be simple. So the formula for success is very simple, but it is difficult to implement, right? The formula for success is very simple. It says, my dear students, whichever course you do, if you have the right set of knowledge, skills, and attitude, jobs are waiting for you. Success is waiting for you. The entire world is waiting for you. This is the only formula for success which I can tell you. Thank you for waiting for us, for shifting from Microsoft Teams to Zoom. And thanks to Sheetal and Dr. Shalini for improvising things in such a seamless manner. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Swami. I think the presentation almost covered every aspect because knowing that we had students from all the three streams here, there are quite a few of them who are BTech aspirants. There are law aspirants here. There are management aspirants here. So there are quite a few of them over here. And from all the three streams, students are there. There are students who are kind of indecisive at this stage also. I wouldn't blame them. It's good to be confused. And yes, they are a little confused. So first of all, I'd like to ask the students if they have any questions.
Yeah, I have just enabled, the chat was already enabled, but I have enabled the, because this is a small group, enabled the your video as well as you can unmute yourself. So in case you want to ask the question, you can go ahead and ask.
Sir, what is the placement structure after BA honors?
After BA honors?
Yes, sir.
BA you honors mean is which subject?
Sir, economics or BA
honors? Yes, economics is indeed the queen of humanities. So people who do economics, generally they enter into some job like either they do MBA or they have or they join a job like which is of analytical or which involves decision making in its job profile. So that way, after economics honors, companies may hire you, banks may hire you for some analytical kinds of jobs. I must say that there's an equation. We say that commerce minus accounts is economics, right? So commerce is something which is close to economics. If you have done BA honors in economics, then obviously you are going to have a job profile which is of business-like, which is of management or MBA kind of. Yes, Priyanshu.
Sir, here I have a leading question. Priyanshu, do you want to ask something more to sir?
Yes, ma'am. ये scholarship structure में जो था एक economically weaker section का खाली छोड़ा था उसका भी कुछ होता है मतलब
Priyanshu, let me tell you that if you belong to the economically weaker section, fee is not a worry for you. The government is there to worry for you. So if you belong to that section, then your tuition fee will definitely be funded by the government of Delhi. But this funding happens once you become a student of any university in Delhi like IPU. You complete your 1 year, and in second year, because these scholarships are based on your scores of first year.
Sir, right. I got this question from Ansh. He's written to me. So Ansh is writing, can you tell me about fees for B Pharma, colleges for B Pharma, and the career placements for B Pharma?
Yes. As far as IPU is concerned, as I said, the fee structures are in the economy range. They generally range between 80,000 and 1,10,000, maybe little more, little less. That's about the fee structure. Indeed, the fee structures at IPU are towards the lower side, right? I must say that it's like traveling in second sleeper in a rail, where you can go for 600 kilometers in 300 rupees. So the fee structure is like that. And because it's a government university, that is the reason why the fee structure is, I must say, controlled or streamlined. Lower fee structure does not mean that the quality of education is poor, right? Rather, in our country, it's the other way around. Lower the fee structure, better the quality of education. DU has got very low fee structures. JNU has got very low fee structures. So even the IITs, they have very low fee structures. So and it's because of government funding. So this is about the fee structure of pharmacy. As far as colleges are concerned, you need to check the list because there are around 95 to 100 colleges in IPU. And how many of them have B Pharma, I cannot tell you the names now. You can just check the list, or Dr. Shalini can share the link of the list of colleges with the courses there. Right, that's about the colleges. As far as scope is concerned, we talked about that. Either you can become a scientist, or you can become a medical representative, or even starting a medical store sounds to be a very good career option after B Pharma.
Sir, I meant placements like provided from the your side. I mean, like, okay, what is the percentage?
As far as pharma is concerned, Ansh, I can tell you that with COVID, the government was caught napping. We found that the percentage of GDP which we were spending on the health sector was very less. It was roughly 1.5% of our GDP. So, in the post-COVID era, health is going to be a sector where governments are going to invest. So, placements are going to be there in the government sector. Plus, when we talk about pharma companies, there are large number of pharma companies which have their production facilities. You name any pharma company, whether it is Glaxo or Cipla or Dr. Reddy's or any pharma company, all of them, they are considered to be good paymasters. If you are asking about the packages, I can tell you that Glaxo, say, for a medical representative, the starting salary is 50,000 per month. For Cipla, it is 30,000 per month, to quote examples.
And so specialization, like for pharma only, is there any specialization?
Specializations within B Pharma?
Yes, sir. Yes. And also in if biotech, if there is any.
Biotech is something which is not doing well in India, for the reason that biotech is a research-based area, and our country is not spending much on biotech or microbiology researches. So engineering in biotech and BSc biotech, once they became popular, but then there was a problem with jobs as far as biotech is concerned. What was your question pertaining to pharmacy?
Specialization.
Now see, students, please try to understand that at graduation level, specializations are not there. Specializations come up only at the post-graduation level. Say, for example, if you do BBA, it's BBA. It's not BBA in marketing or finance. But while you do MBA, it is MBA in marketing or finance, right? Say, if you do BSc, it is PCM or PCB. But when you do MSc, it is MSc chemistry, or even within chemistry, there are branches like causist and all that. So specializations, say for example, MBBS. MBBS, what is the specialization in MBBS? It's not there, it's general, but while you do MD or MS, you have specializations. So if you will do M Pharma, you may be specializing in any field, but if you do B Pharma, graduations are general in nature.
So there is another question from Harsh. He's writing, which is the best college for BTech, CSE, needed JEE rank, which is required. I think, Harsh, you are asking for the IP University, the JEE rank, which is required. Companies that are visiting for placements and the average pay package.
I'll go point wise. Which college is best? Well, I've already answered that question. It's not the college or any course which is good, bad, or ugly. It's how you acquire the knowledge, skill set, attitude. My dear students, you look at any college in this world, you'll find that some students are definitely doing very well and some are not. And as I said, the majority are happy and satisfied. So, you know, it's a misnomer that this college is good or this is bad. If 30% IIT products fail in their careers, are the IITs good or bad? But anyway, to answer your question, well, the rankings are available. There are, as far as BTech is concerned, maybe there are 15 colleges which are providing BTech. And I think IBU colleges, all of them are reasonable. They have got good laboratories. If you want to decide which college is good, the best thing is visit the college. You see what kind of computers they have, how they have their laboratories, what are the qualifications of the teachers, and the teachers shown on their website are really available there or not. So all those things you can check. You can check the library. For engineering, yes, laboratories are very important. You visit the lab, you ask, okay, how many computers you have, and what are these computers, i3 or i5 or i7. So such queries can tell you whether a college is, how good a college is, right? Talking about the companies which recruit BTechs, well, again, I'll stick to computer science. You name any company in the world, and Indians are very popular over there. All of us are aware of how Indians are now going on to become the CEOs of the best companies in the world, be it Sundar Pichai or be it the recent Insta head, he's what, Parag Agarwal. So Indians, you know, I don't know, we can engage into some self-praise, but as far as IT sector is concerned, computer science is concerned, Indians are ruling the world. So each and every company, you name any company, and they are recruiting Indians. They are holding campus drives in almost all the IPU colleges. Yes.
So he's asking for the JE rank, which is required as okay. well.
So rank again is is something which is in relative terms. Say, for example, your rank may not be good, still may you may be able to get a good college. Your rank may be good, you may not be able to get a good college. Your rank is not so good, still you get a good college. So rank is something which, you know, keeps on fluctuating year on year. So rank is, I cannot tell you that if you get, say, if X is the number which rank you must have, you can get a college, something like that. We cannot say. These things keep on changing. You need to get a rank. You just attempt JEE properly, get a rank, and you apply for colleges, and then you visit the colleges, whichever college suits you, you take admission in that college, right? So that way, answering the rank question is difficult.
Any further questions? I don't have any question on my chat. So if you have any further questions?
Sir, is baar CU CET hoga to pehle to IP apne khud ke examination leta tha. So is baar CU CET ke basis pe hi hoga admission.
You are talking about
sir common entrance test.
A common entrance test for which university?
Sir, jaise DU conduct kara raha hai is baar CU CET.
Beta, DU ne ab tak to nahi karwaya. Ab ki baar keh rahe ki karwayenge, lekin har baar kehte hain karwayenge. To I don't know this year they'll hold entrance exam or not, because again, as I said, DU is known for admitting students through that 12th percentage. While IPU says no to 12th percentage, IPU says entrance is required. DU, yes, I read in the newspapers that it's going to hold its entrance exams, but in my opinion, it's not possible. Bahut mushkil hai. They'll go by the same percentage. This is my opinion.
और सर डोमेन स्पेसिफिक कितने मार्क्स का होता है एग्जामिनेशन?
वेल एज फार एज द एंट्रेंस टेस्ट्स आर कंसर्न्ड इन जनरल यू हैव इंग्लिश यू हैव मैथ्स और रीजनिंग व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू कॉल इट और मेंटल एप्टीट्यूड दीज आर ऑल यू नो डिफरेंट नेम्स ऑफ ऑलमोस्ट द सेम थिंग वेदर इट इज मैथमेटिक्स और मेंटल एप्टीट्यूड और रीजनिंग एंड देन so GK, English and mental ability. These three are invariably part of any entrance exam, right? Now, as far as the domain specific marks are concerned, I think we can hold a separate webinar for that because every exam has got different domain specific marks. I can quote an example for CLAT for which the forms are already open. So in CLAT, there are 5 domains. So while you appear for CLAT, it is like English, GK, reasoning, and then there is something like legal aptitude also. So there are 5 domains as far as CLAT is concerned. If you want, you can tell Sheetal ma'am and we can hold a separate webinar wherein we'll tell you that, say for any entrance, these are the specific domains. Dr. Shalini, we can hold a webinar for CLAT at least, because the CLAT forms are already open.
We do conduct, like, just to inform you, last year we conducted when the CLAT forms were open, how to prepare for CLAT. Like sir said, there are 5 sections. So we took 1-hour marathon, this thing. The students who are interested only in, in pursuing law as a career, how to prepare for CLAT. We conduct those webinars. We also conducted webinars how to build your, qualitative, quantitative aptitude skills, how to build your English vocab. Because generally, kya hota hai ki jo hum class 11, 12th mein ya school mein hum English padh rahe hote hain, aur jo entrance exams mein aa raha hota hai, usme difference rehta hai, right? So we do conduct the exams. We have a tie-up with the various coaching institutes as well, where we conduct those 1-2-hour. Workshop kind of thing for the interested students. So those details, that can come in that, right? There are a few more questions in the chat box now. I don't know. It's already 2, so probably last 1 or 2 questions, sir, with your due permission, we can take.
Yes,
Adarsh is asking, which are some good entrance exams which should be taken into consideration for science students other than JEE?
Other than JEE, what should I say? NDA? NDA is like when we talk about NDA.
Usme science chahiye, yes.
For Air Force and Navy, you need science. For Army, you do not. So Army is stream neutral and Air Force, Navy are stream specific. NDA is yes. Other than JEE, NDA is one exam. Then CLAT obviously is there. And then if you have biology, then MBBS is there. So what I can suggest is NDA and CLAT. Even for this journalism, for BBA, for hotel management, well, science students, although these are stream neutral courses, but science students, they do well in these courses.
Sir, yes. Probably we can take this last question. This is from Aditi. She's asking, does your university offer design courses for undergraduates? If yes, do you have entrances specifically for
them? Yes, a few colleges are offering.
Yeah, from this year, and because it has started from this year only, so you need to appear for UCED for IP university exams.
Right.
So UCED exam you need to prepare for, which is done by IIT Bombay. So the scores of UCED exams will be taken for the design colleges in IP University as well. Like JEE ke scores we take the IP University. Similarly for design courses, UCED score would be applicable for IP University colleges.
So the design courses are very much there.
Yes, they're there.
So, Dr. Shalini,
the student is interested in designing what? Footwear or attire or what? Or aeroplanes?
I think she's talking about fashion design.
BJS
so that, hai, that is there. Yes.
Yeah, fashion BJS hai, bachelor in design.
Yeah.
So yeah. That includes whole lot of thing, not only fashion. Right. So it is there. IP University is giving it. Very few colleges under IP Universities, but it is there.
But it's there.
Yeah.
Right. So what I'll do is I'll look forward to the list of IP universities and the colleges. I think I have one downloaded. I'll share it with you, Dr. Shalini. You can always approve whether that's the latest one.
Sure.
I have one with me and I will share it with the students because I did a little homework before this research, before this session.
Right.
So I will share that list with you. And once I share that list with you, you can approve it. I'll share it with the students. Any other questions you have, you can always forward them to me and I can check with Dr. Shalini and Dr. Swami can always revert on those questions, right? Sure. Dr. Swami, I'm just assuming that you will. I'm taking
definitely,
it.
Definitely, we will.
If you permit, I can share my number with the students. If they have the questions with reference to the IP University, they can always send me the WhatsApp or, you know, probably it is not always possible to take the calls, but if you send me a message, you can rest assured that you will get the reply from me. So I'll just share the number in the chat box. 89209811152. So this is the number. So best is to drop a message so that I can reply after verifying the facts and all. So any questions you have regarding the IP University, you can always get in touch with us.
And Dr. Shalini, we will look forward to certain webinars on CLAT, though we have few students because right now the strength is thin, but we have few students who are preparing for CLAT.
Right.
I would, if you can even have a club session with other schools when you're just conducting one. So a bigger group, they have more questions who are somebody's asking and the solves their queries also.
So,
I look forward to those kind of sessions. Thank you very much. Despite a lot of technical issues, we have been able to successfully conduct this session.
All is well that ends well. So
absolutely.
Ending well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. No doubt about that.
Yeah.
Students, if you have any more questions, please direct them to Dr. Shalini or me. And we will definitely get in touch with you, with Dr. Swami. Dr. Swami, I'm looking forward to interacting more with you. Definitely. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you, students. Thank you very much for being so patient with us.